What we call the fourth wall is the imaginary space between the story and the ones experiencing it. When the gap between audience and characters is bridged, this is known as breaking the fourth wall. There are times when a character will look through the wall and address the audience directly, or even just acknowledge that they are in some kind of medium. All right, YouTube? Some incredible examples of breaking the fourth wall in video games can be seen in Metal Gear Solid. From the Psycho Mantis fight, to changing controller ports, to checking the back of the game's CD case to find a secret codec. In the case of Metal Gear, it's a way of poking fun or letting the audience in on some kind of secret in a brilliantly interactive way. But there's plenty other video games where breaking the fourth wall can be unsettling and even terrifying. Not even the glass of your screen is strong enough to keep you safe from these video game characters, because they can see you too. I am Rach, welcome back to What Culture Gaming. There are spoilers all the way through this video, check the timecode for details, but these are 7 terrifying times that video games broke the fourth wall.
But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to stay notified. Ding, ding, done.
Number 7, Undertale, They Remember. Undertale is a game that sticks with you after you play it, but funnily enough, you also stick with Undertale. Throughout the game, the characters not only remember you, but also acknowledge your ability to save and reload the game. Right at the start of the game, you are rescued by the kind and caring Toriel, who not only cooks for you a nice wee pie, but also provides for you a safe haven to live. It's all very rosy and sweet until you decide to leave. Toriel pleads with us to stay, even going as far as forcing you to face her in battle. Accidentally or otherwise, if you choose to strike Toriel, she is killed instantly, materializing like the fragments of our own broken hearts. Oops. In a fit of panic and regret, you may restart the game to try and save her. But it is when you do this that you are made aware of the chilling fact that Undertale remembers. Flowey knows what you did, making you aware that all the way through your playthrough, you are being watched, and judgment is coming. Whew. Number 6, Battlefield 1, The Trusty Narrator. One of the most outlandish missions in Battlefield 1's campaign mode is also one of the most enjoyable, but it's got a dark twist. Friends in High Places sees you take on the role of pilot slash con man, Clyde Blackburn. He's a stand-up kind of guy. He teams up with Gunner Wilson, and the pair face increasingly dangerous and extraordinary missions, even somehow single-handedly winning the Battle of Britain. Yet, as this story comes to a close, there's a wee voice niggling in your ear going, well, this is all very realistic. Blackburn insists that his version of events is true, showing a zooming shot of his past self, stating, what you've heard from me is the truth. I wouldn't tell you if it wasn't. But then Blackburn himself looks through the camera at us, cuts off the narration and goes, would I? The screen cuts to black and we are left horrified at the thought that all of these heroic deeds, the characters, the stories that we had emotionally invested in, and this true story we were reliving was probably just one big heaping pile of shit. Number 5, Pony Island, Trolling the Player. Disguised as a platform runner where you take a cute little pony and jump over fences and blow away tickling butterflies as you go, Pony Island starts off by making fun of our insatiable need to constantly be rewarded. Eventually, the game just simply overloads from rewarding you so much and begins to show its true dark nature. Before long, the machine announces that it can no longer accept tickets or coins for you to continue playing. What it really needs is your soul to keep fueling the machine. Turns out it's actually possessed by a demonic being that has absorbed the souls of many a player before you. This trickery gets actually more and more dastardly and terrifying as the game goes along, from convincing you to write down some pretty dirty nasty phrases, only to then publish them on Steam for all your friends to see, to the soul of a former player convincing you the only way to save them is by uninstalling the game. It's brave, it's brilliant, it's terrifying, and I bloody love it. Number 4. Eternal Darkness, Sanity's Requiem. Real insanity. As you might have guessed from the title, Eternal Darkness plays with the concept of a sanity meter, with many of the game's mechanics making you feel like you are approaching insanity yourself. When a player's sanity bar falls too low, strange events begin to occur not only in the game, but also in reality itself. There are several insanity effects that mess with your TV display, turning the screen off, making insects crawl all over it, or even make it look as if it's lowering your volume. The game can even be as cruel as to give you a blue screen of death, falsely tell you your controller needs to be plugged in, or even congratulate you on finishing the game's demo. Occasionally, you'll go to save your game and you'll be met with a prompt saying, "Would you like to delete all your saved data?" And the only answers are yes or continue without saving. I mean, neither answer actually causes any data to be deleted, but it's still unexpected enough to give you a heck of a fright. Number 3, X-Men. Reset the computer. In the action beat-em-up simply known as X-Men for the Sega Mega Drive and the Genesis, there's a stage called Mojo Crunch, in which at the end the player is told they need to reboot the Danger Room by resetting the computer. This happens after you've already, of course, explored all the level, defeated all the enemies, and of course the boss. You explore the stage, looking around for any sort of hint or just some kind of direction on what to do, looking for some kind of computer to reset. And then it clicks. By resetting the computer, the game is actually referring to your console. In complete disbelief, we press the soft reset button on our Sega, and this causes a Matrix-esque green text to come up on the screen, followed by a message telling you that the infectious virus has been subdued. And exhale. This method of the console itself actually being used as a gameplay prompt was highly unexpected for a game that came out in 1994. Because this actually predates all of the Metal Gear Solid shenanigans. Number 2, Nier. Sacrifice yourself. There's something very precious about our save games, and too bloody right, those are dozens of hours of blood and sweat, and in some cases, tears. Nier taps right into this obsession. The original Nier had an array of alternate endings before alternate endings became as trendy as cat cafes. One of these lets Nier sacrifice his own existence to save his possessed companion, Kaine. You think to yourself, well, that sounds like a much more pleasant option than driving a sword through her chest, so you go with that one. But sacrificing yourself actually means deleting all of your save data, wiping everything you have achieved. The game even asks you several times whether this is actually what you really want. And then all your inventory, your map, your save game screens start disintegrating before your eyes. It's pretty traumatic, and you actually wonder for a moment if it's even going to be worth it. Thankfully, the ending is a poignant payoff and makes your very real sacrifice all worth it. And it actually provides some pretty good closure for the game. Now to never play that heart-wrenching game ever again, I'll look a sequel! And number 1, Doki Doki Literature Club, Monica's Prison. Doki Doki Literature Club is a weird game. It's a roller coaster journey of emotions and surprises, relationships, absolutely genius game design that completely shatters expectations. It not only features fourth wall breakages that are terrifying, but also emotionally shattering. You begin by playing through what appears to be a stereotypical high school dating sim. As you progress through the game, things start going from adorable to oh my god. As the game reaches its finale, character Monica begins to rob you of your freedom of choice, even going as far as deleting her fellow club members, quite literally erasing their data files from your computer and destroying her own universe just so the two of you can be the last things in it. She even learns your real name through your computer settings. Ugh. Whether you felt scared into doing it, or vengeful, or curious, whatever reason that you chose to go into your game's directory and delete Monica's character file, I guarantee that you had an emotionally difficult time doing it. And that's because Monica felt real. She knew she was a character in a video game, but she still felt love, lust, loneliness, jealousy, and regret. Oh, I've got goosebumps. Now that is one hell of a fourth wall bulldozing. There we go, guys. Thank you so much for sticking with us, Johnny, Sarah, Michael, and Laura. Be sure to pop us a like, comment down below all those nuggets of wisdom. Subscribe if you want to see more lists like this. We post every single day. But if you want to see something right now, over here we have 8 unexpected video game jump scares that scarred you for life. Another wee spooky one. Or over here, got more of my fine self. And some of the other gaming guys in 12 more hilarious video game translation errors. Might give you a wee giggle. Thank you again for watching. We have been What Culture, and you, I just wanted to say your hair looks really nice today. See you again.